All right, guys, we are live. Episode 164 of the Shooter's Mindset. Thank you guys for tuning in tonight. Co-host, he's back again.
How's it going, guys?
joining us here, Nikki Clevenger. What's going on, Nikki?
Hey, guys.
It's going pretty good. Jennifer might be joining us. I think she's caught up in the Apple Store insanity. They tell you 40 minutes and they'll see you when you really end up waiting about 2 hours.
That's why I got that Android phone, son.
That Android? Yeah. Samsung?
Yeah.
Got my SHOT Show app up.
Yeah.
Yeah. The guest, the star of the hour, Kevin Hayes, National Sales Manager of Edge Tactical Eyewear. What's going on, Kevin?
Hey, thanks, Anthony. Great to be here. Appreciate you having us.
I appreciate you coming on here. We got a lot to talk about, man, because I'm a skeptic, man, but I'm highly interested in how you could get so much technology into these. I mean, they look really great, you know, and I use another brand, so that's why I'm looking for some convincing here. You know, I can tell you what, the price range is in my wallet. You know, that fits my wallet, the price range. I can tell you that. But how can we get so much technology into that? That's what we're going to talk about here in the beginning of the show here. But show sponsors and people who really support us and been doing this since the beginning of last year, or they've been on for a few years, and one of those people are Tactical Shit, okay? And shop.tacticalshit.com is the website, their internet website, where they have a bunch of stuff. I mean, clothing, targets, gun parts, you know.
Eyewear.
Yeah. And that's the thing. We're going to talk about Edge Tactical Eyewear here, but from what the website that I'm on, you can't purchase them directly through Edge. So you have to find a dealer like Tactical Shit. I mean, Optics Planet has them. There's a lot of people that carry these. Seen a ton of them on eBay too. We got a discount for you guys coming on Tactical Shit, shop.tacticalshit. So stay tuned for that. If you want to pick up a pair, you can get 10% off them too. Speaking of them, they got a new retail shop over in St. Louis, right off of 70 and St. Peter's.
Yeah,
it's right? The 3,000 square feet of retail.
Yeah, it's the right? Cave Springs exit. It's the if you're familiar with St. Louis, it's the old Uncle Sam's, and it's like that whole shopping center. So they're doing it up big and right. So that's going to be pretty crazy.
Right on. So go check them out if you're in the St. Louis, Missouri area, or if you want to take a drive. I'm sure it's worth it to go see those guys, goof around with them, and check out all the gear in the shop. S3F Solutions for a fine match grade Glock drop and barrel. Threaded, fluted, stainless, titanium nitride, black nitride. They got it all the fancy stuff. All the cool kids are doing it. You should too. They have some 308 bulk carrier groups. A lot of stuff over there. Go visit sdfsolutions.com for more info on them. Q&A section. Best way to do it, I'm going to say, head over to the Shooter's Mindset Facebook page. We got a post that just went up. Put your comments right below that post for anything Edge Tactical Eyewear related or anything you want to ask us. You can do it there. If you're watching on the YouTube feed, it'll be in the top right-hand corner. It's like join the conversation thing. I'll pull those. And theshootersmindset.com, okay, for all your news. Read the blogs, watch the show, shop around for some very cool gear. We're going to talk about possibly getting an Edge Tactical Eyewear into the Shooter's Mindset shop. Why not, right? I'm digging it so far. So head over to shootersmindset.com, keep up with everything there. We put out a great blog article yesterday focusing on shot calling and a perfect sight picture, or not so perfect sight picture is the name of that article. All right. So Kevin, for those who aren't familiar with you, tell us a little bit more about yourself and about Edge Tactical as a company.
I'll be happy to. As far as me, I came over, I'm retired Army, and was working with Streamlight's military team for the last 5 years. And the opportunity came up to come over to Edge Tactical Eyewear and be the national sales manager. And, you know, it was a great fit. I love the product. Like, you know, you were talking about earlier, Anthony, I love the price point. I think that it's a tremendous value. And the other thing that I like is a challenge of really educating customers on eyewear, eye protection versus sunglasses, you know, needing versus wanting. And, you know, just really happy to do that. Edge Eyewear itself started making safety glasses about 20 years ago. We are in the U.S. and in Canada, and we have a new international division, so we're selling in Europe, Latin America, and Asia as well. So the tactical line is about 4 years old, and I'm going to walk through a few things here just to kind of show you some of the differences here. Our basic entry-level range class, as you can see here, it's called Fastlink. Got three different lens colors. Most of our lens colors are clear. We call our amber tiger's eye, and then our smoke is actually nice job, Dustin. Our smoke is actually called G15, and G15. Thanks. G15 is actually an Air Force term. What they did was, back in the 1950s, the Air Force was having a problem with aviation shields, and the sun and the glare of the sun with that gray color for the were flying. So what they did was they introduced a green tint to that gray smoke lens. And what the green tint does is actually cools down the eye, which reduces eye strain and eye fatigue. So we were able to take that technology and put it into our gray smoke lenses to actually give you a fit and a feel that is much better than the standard gray smoke lens. So this frame right here, as you can see, I can bend it. The tips, they're not going to break. The eyewear is all. And I'm going to bring this up here, try to show that. Can you see that?
Yeah,
that's a little keychain that we do, and you kind of see that lens right there. Now try to bring it over. This is one of the lenses that we shoot. We shoot it with a number 7 bird shot to test for ballistics. So it's 1200. It's 12 gauge shotgun, 12 yards away, 1200 feet per second. So that's a ballistic rating. That's a ballistic standard. And we have these at every trade show that we have out to show people. So. You know, we really feel like we've got a great value. We've got some really stylish lenses and frames. Of course, not everybody's going to look as pretty as Dustin and his, but, you know, we're going to try to see what we can do.
Hey, when you got this much style going down, it's hard to catch
that's
up.
That's right. It's hard to get that much on one human being. Yeah, it really is.
I mean, I could put a few more.
I'm going to walk over here a second. I'm going to pull this up. Display. And if you can kind of see here to this side, I have polarized styles lenses, and on this side we have what are called vapor shield lenses. And what I'd like to do is real quickly, you can see a close steamer here. Can you see the steam coming out of it?
Yeah.
You can see that. What I'm going to do is take a competitive pair. This is about the best way to show you. And I'm not telling you who made those glasses. Can you see that?
Yeah.
You see the brand name on that?
Yeah.
Allow, but can you see it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Those guys make pretty good glasses, right? So here's what happens normally with ballistic eyewear, right? You seen that?
I own a pair of those.
That's about a $100 pair of glasses right there that are absolutely useless right now for me to shoot with. However, I can take a $16 pair of Edge Tactical Eyewear, Fastlink, do the same thing. What do you see?
Hmm.
Any fogging?
Nope.
Interesting.
Well, you can do it again. No tricks. Nothing up my sleeve. That's why I wore short sleeves. I'm trying to aim this well. So the vapor shield does work. I don't want to bore you with a lot of the science, but basically the vapor shield is a chemical compound that's embedded into the lens. So when that lens is in a liquid form, we inject the vapor shield compound in there. And what that does is when the lens hardens and stabilizes, that anti-fog treatment is actually all the way through the lens. Up, down, side to side, inside and out. So it's not like a spray or a wipe that you get with other manufacturers. It's actually embedded into the lens. Yeah, that's why it works. That's why we warranty it.
What's that, Dustin?
Yeah, I was going to say, it's not like that,
That's why we're able to warranty it with the product. Yeah. So, got some other stuff here. If you'd like to talk about any styles in particular, we do a line of goggles. Dustin was modeling one earlier. I have a goggle. We have an Overlord kit, as you can see right over here. It's a really nice. I'm trying to look real quick. Yeah, see it. I'm seeing just a real small portion on my screen.
Yeah, we don't have a good shot of it.
It's a four lens kit. It's a four lens kit. With the kit, you get a polarized lens, you get a clear lens, you get a G15 smoke lens, and a tiger's eye lens. You get a Molly compatible carry case. You get two leashes, and you get a cleaning bag. And I think you guys have something very special to announce about the Overlord kit.
Yeah, we're gonna give away an Overlord kit. Now, since this was on the fly and Kevin just brought this up, we didn't have our giveaway set up for this. So what we're going to do is we're going to put it together after the show. Just something simple. You just go to this link, you know, and you pretty much enter there. You like put in your name and email or whatever, and you get to check these out. We're going to give one set away. So you're going to get the polarized and all the three other lenses. You're going to get a whole nice little kit. We're going to give away a set just for you guys to check out. Thank you guys for watching this year's Mindset, and to check out Edge Tactical Eyewear when you guys get a chance. If you don't win them, you can go ahead and purchase them. They're everywhere, that kit.
Yeah. Please.
Let's say, can I enter that?
Maybe.
Do I count if I win?
You got fake emails? You got fake email addresses? Yeah. Yeah. Why is his name Mike Honcho on his email? That's weird.
Who's Mike Honcho?
That's his email. I don't know. It's weird.
My husband's email says Mike Honcho?
Yeah. You got to ask him about that.
You're throwing him under the bus. That's probably the email that she doesn't know about, okay?
No, y'all, it's user error probably.
Yeah. All right. But Kevin, I got to ask you here. I've never tried a pair of Edge. I've been an Oakley guy for a long time here. We've talked about other brand glasses on the show here before. So how can you squeeze all this technology? You talked about the Vapor Shield. You talked about ballistics. You showed us a pair of that with Buckshot there. You showed us the flexible frames already. How can you put all that together at half the cost of some of your major competitors?
Well, a couple things, Anthony. First of all, that's a great question. But what we try to do is at Edge, we're a small company, and we run very lean. So we don't bring in, we don't have an unlimited marketing budget. You're not going to see Edge billboards and, you know, Edge sponsoring, you know, the Super Bowl or anything like that. We work within our means. And it's a very responsible company in that shape. The thing about Oakley and Under Armour and some of the other lifestyle brands is that you know they've developed a brand and they have consumers' trust and they have consumers' confidence, and that's great for what they do. The issue with safety, with ballistic safety rated eyewear, is that you need the professionals' trust. You need the professionals' confidence. If I'm going to pick up a firearm, I've got to know that my eyes are protected. You know, if I'm a police officer and I'm going on duty, if I'm a shooting hobbyist and I go out to the rifle range on the weekends, I have to know that my eyes are protected. So one of the things that we do is we try to really dive down and make sure that everything we make is communicated as such that it's ballistic rated. And it's also safety rated. So we don't have a line of, fancy, non-ballistic, non-safety eyewear, or we don't have a line of men's clothing or women's shoes. All we make is ballistic safety rated eyewear. And you see some of the features and benefits in there. So what we're doing is we're really focusing on building the best product we can make for professionals and earning the trust of professionals going forward.
There you go, right on. I mean, and what do we – give us a general ballpark. I mean, what's the price range of – I know you guys offer tons of models, and we're going to talk about sure. all the different designs that they offer here.
Okay.
But what's the general price range from, you know, to the lowest cost to maybe the highest cost?
Okay. I'm going to hold some of these up. This is the Fast Link again that we talked. This is a basic shooting glass. I recommend this if you're going to the range to qualify. You're going to wear it for, I don't know, an hour or two maybe. It's very comfortable to wear. It's got a thermoplastic rubber nose piece in here, which the more moist and warm your face gets, the better they stick to your nose. So they're not going to slide down your nose, so you're not constantly losing your eye protection. This is $15.95 at retail. So that's our basic entry glass. When you get more into some of the other features and benefits, I've got cans on this head and showing this. This is called Sharp Edge Thin Temple. This is actually my favorite shooting glass right here. We have it in the three different lens colors, the clear, the tiger's eye, and the G15. But as you can see right here, you can see right there, it's a very, very thin temple on the side. So what that's going to do for shooters, if you're wearing cans, if you're wearing comms, if you're wearing a helmet that's constantly pushing down on the ear, you're not going to get head pinch. So these are actually rated for up to 12 hours with no head pinch. And again, you get the ballistic frames, the ballistic lenses. You get the TR90 nylon frames, which aren't going to break. And it's a very, very comfortable fit. They probably look better on the mannequin than me, but I'll model them for you there for a little bit. But these are $29.95. We're working on a kit right now to actually have multiple lenses in these. Right now, this is a single lens kit, but you can get this for clear, tiger's eye, or the G15. This is a great, great glass. Again, it's called Sharp Edge Thin Temple. It's my favorite shooting glass that I've worn.
$29, guys, for...
$29.95. That's at retail. That's at full retail. Another very popular glass that we have is called the Blade Runner. I'm going to put this here. The Blade Runner. It's a great style. It's a combination of rubber. Thanks, Dustin. of rubber and nylon. And the great thing about this one is we make two different sizes. So you can actually fit every, if you're buying for a SWAT team, if you're buying for a group of people, you can actually fit everyone from a peanut head to a pumpkin head. As you can see here, different size frames.
Yeah.
Really a cool combination. Now, in this one, in this style, we do offer a gradient polarized lens. So when you get into the higher price points, this is $40 at retail, $39.95, and the polarized versions are $69.95. And there's no price change between the regular fit and the extra large fit. The Hamel styles that you see, the Hamel, this one happens to be thin temple. This is called the Gray Wolf. Dustin's got the black one with a clear lens there. This is a little different one. These are $49.95.
Those are in my car.
Again, the
right
thin
now.
Temple on the side. The thin temple makes for a very, very comfortable fit. You look good in those, man.
Yeah. The gray ones are actually.
And we do.
So we're good to go.
We do offer like a tan version. You can see like a desert tan, which is really popular. Military plus out west. I noticed like El Paso, Texas.
Arizona guys shooting in
the
desert.
Arizona, exactly. Thank you.
Yeah.
And then we also have, this is our most expensive single lens glass. This is a multi-cam Hamel polarized. This is $79.95 all in. So it's a very good looking.
$79. It's like, this is our most expensive
looking. $79.95.
You're thinking like Tissot, like $185, right?
Exactly.
Kevin?
Yeah. Well, our we were talking earlier about our Legends Guardian, the entire kit with the glass, the custom cleaning bag, the tactical patch, and everything is only $79.95 all in. So
So
we're doing the
it's an awesome value for the average shooter to the competition shooter to anybody. And
I mean, it is. And it's,
I grew up at Lake of the Ozarks, so I grew up on the water, and I had a $200 pair of Oakleys that you take one turn on my Wave Runner and then bloop, they're in the lake. So I grew up on gas station $20 sunglasses, you know? And so when I found Edge, and you know, I rocked the Hamels, or I got the blades as well. Mm-hmm. And you know, for 50, 60, 70 bucks, and I crack, you know, somehow I break them or I lose them, I'm not crying myself in the corner in the fetal position because I just lost a $200 pair of glasses. You know, it's doable. It's even, it's worth, you can expense it every other year. I have my first pair is actually sitting on my office desk right now. But I mean, they're used day in and day out, 4 or 5 days a week. Being an instructor and being also a competition shooter, I could wear them Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So I'm literally wearing them and using them and abusing them. And I'm not very easy on any of my gear. I put, sorry about it, but, you know, and I used it and abused it. And that's where I was like, damn, these things hold up. I'm not going to cry even if I do break them. And that's why I started wearing them. And that's why I helped, you know, hollered at Anthony and I was like, hey, you need to check these out. So, you know, I definitely use them.
We appreciate it. Yeah, our company is made up of shooters. We're made up of people who are, you know, competitive bike riders that need eye protection. You know, so we're constantly going to the company with input on the next generation. And our owner actually is an avid shooting sportsman. So he gets the fact that, you know, they have to be comfortable. They have to look good. That's why we put, as you can see on the displays here, that's why we put a mirror on every display, because no matter how big, how tough, how brawny somebody comes in and wants to look at eye protection, the first thing they do is put on the glasses and then look at themselves in a mirror.
It's all about looking good, really. I mean, that's absolutely really the number one thing.
You gotta rock the
and
gear.
Then the safety thing. Then the safety comes second.
And then the safety comes after. But the great thing about ours is, you know you're going to look good, and the better part is, you know you're going to be protected. Yeah. So a lot of people really don't understand safety ratings and ballistic ratings. Like if you go to Home Depot or Walmart, they're going to have shelves of 99-cent, $2 safety rated glasses. Yeah. Safety rating is great if you're dropping something heavy on a glass. If you got a piece of steel that you're going to drop straight down on a lens, that's great. But what about high velocity, high impact? You know, like we just talked about with the buckshot. That is a separate, complete separate rating. That's called MCEPS, Military Combat Eye Protection System. And that's your ballistic rating. That's the high velocity, high impact. So when you're looking for glasses that you're going to use to shoot with, you really need to make sure that they're not only ANSI approved, but they're MCEPS approved too. And so with our eyewear, again, every single pair of glasses that we make are both ANSI rated and MCEPS rated. And the other thing is too, I showed you this company, this glass that fogs up right behind me. They're one of the companies, and there are a bunch of other ones out there that do their own certifications. Edge is one of the very few companies in the ballistic safety rated eyewear industry that actually uses a third party testing facility to certify all of our eyewear. And it's the same testing facility actually down there where Anthony is, down in Florida, Colts Laboratories. They actually certify that we are compliant in the U.S. with ANSI and MCEPS, in Canada with CSA, and in Europe with the EN166 standard. So, you know, no matter if you're a casual shooter or if you're a competitive shooter, everybody in between, one of the great things that you need to do for yourself, we're starting for a new year. Everybody's got New Year's resolutions. Defend your vision. Make sure that the glasses you're wearing and protecting your eyes are both ANSI rated. Make sure they're MCEPS rated. Make sure you're defending your vision and protect your eyes.
Yeah, and for law enforcement guys and military guys, they're actually also uniform dress code. You got the green light on that too, so you don't have to worry about getting something and then your NCO is like negative. Throw those $200 glasses away. You can't rock those. So no, you're good to go. So that was another good one.
No cops had dress code on there.
There's some sergeants. I know some dudes. There are some sergeants that are pretty hardcore. Obviously, it's all on your department.
That's good.
And all of that. But definitely, obviously, in the military side is a little bit more.
Sure.
Calling BS on your story.
Well, I mean, I'm not calling BS. I'm just saying.
I see how it is, Nikki. First,
I know that, like, here, if you're in uniform, you can't have, like, a beard. You can only have a mustache.
Oh.
That's a weird, dress code type thing. Like, but you can have a mustache.
Big, bushy, handlebar mustache. That's what he needs to rock next time.
I think you're going to see a lot more of that as more Iraq and Afghanistan war veterans come back and join police departments. I think you're going to start to see the overall standards, appearance standards, start to raise up. I'm not going to call it paramilitary, but I do think that they're going to actually come up. I've talked to a lot of some of the younger decision makers, the quartermasters, the SWAT leaders, in many departments across the country. Many of them have been in the war during the last 10 to 15 years. And we're starting to see some of this stuff. Well, I want the same stuff I had on active duty. That's the same stuff I trust. So I think, you know, for law enforcement, I really hope that the conversation starts changing of getting away from sunglasses protection and to talk about, you know, I don't care what I look like, to, hey, I'm proud of being in my uniform. So at Edge Tactical Eyewear, we're happy to do that with you know, a tremendous number of different ways, different styles that we can do that.
There you go, right on. Jennifer Seymour's joining us here late, by the way. We're in a good conversation here, so I didn't want to interrupt.
She snuck in.
I wasn't going to interrupt. I was just going to sit here quietly.
She snuck in. And, you know, Jen's been on this show a couple times saying that she has, I don't know, what do you have, a tiny face or something?
Yes, I wear junior kids Oakleys.
Because they're the only ones that are comfortable. Okay.
Legit. I just got these for Christmas from my husband. They are children's Oakleys, and that's what I wear.
Children.
Okay.
Because the adult ones.
Well, how about I upgrade those for you, Jennifer?
All right. You have little
we've got
for little baby faces.
Can you see those?
Can you return them? Don't let them know. Pocket the cash.
That's called Falcon. That's called Falcon, and yeah. it is built for a smaller face. And this is very, very popular with female shooters and male shooters that have a smaller face. We make that in clear, tiger's eye, G15 smoke, and polarized. So I would love for you to try these, and they're ballistic safety rated. So, you know, you can wear them and you can wear them shooting. And I definitely would like to get you out of those junior Oakleys and get you something in safe for your eyes.
Step up your game over.
Those 8-year old kid sunglasses.
I'm telling you, I've tried everything. I've tried ESS. I've tried Rudy. In fact, I have a pair if anybody wants to buy them because they're just, I look like a freaking bug. I look ridiculous in them. I mean, yep. Sure, they're great glasses, but I look ridiculous in them. They're like this big on my face because I'm really narrow right here. And I just look ridiculous in them, and I can't shoot with them because they stick out from my face so far that I can't shoulder anything. So
sure. Are you coming to SHOT Show?
I am.
You are. Please stop by our booth 30011. Try on the Falcon, and I will definitely take for joining us here on the show tonight, and for you all welcoming me in. I'd love to treat you to a pair, Jennifer.
Thank you.
Look at that. Show up late. Got your iPhone fixed.
Show up late and get some iPro.
Get some iPro.
Dead deal.
Look at that.
You just don't know.
She said nothing about the show. All of a sudden, she jumps in here.
This is coming from a guy who had 5 pairs of them on his head before we started. So.
Y'all don't know what I've been through tonight. I've been through war with the Apple Store and Sprint. Somebody from Sprint that didn't speak English. And I was standing in the middle of Apple Store, thereby laughing at me, yelling, "I can't understand you!" So, yeah, that just made my night. You just don't know.
How'd it go again, Jim?
Well, come by SHOT Show. We all speak English. No one will yell at you. And we'll get you a pair of Falcons.
That's excellent.
Yeah, I barely speak English, so I don't know where you're coming from.
And Nikki, you wanted to jump in there with something?
Yeah, I had a question. I find that are they like adjustable, or are they like the frames will like hold on to your head Because I find when I'm shooting my shotgun and it's, you know, I have my face on it, it's rocking me, my glasses start slipping down my face. And I've actually, not necessarily like croakies, but I've actually had like an elastic band that clips into the sides and actually holds it on my face.
Zip tie it to your forehead?
Pretty much. A zip tie would work a whole lot better.
We can fix that. I feel like I'm lurching forward here. We can fix that very easily. You see the sharp edge thin temple here?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to flip these over. You see that nose piece right here?
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to flip this here. This is called a TPR nose piece. And without getting into the science of it too much, it stands for thermoplastic rubber. And what that is, it's a heat-activated material. So the more warm, the more moist your face gets, the better they actually stick to your nose. And they're not going to slide down your face.
Even if you have makeup on?
And with these, it should matter.
Now, Kevin, have you put your makeup on?
Now, can you put some makeup on your face?
Dustin, tell us about when you wear your makeup. How does it work for you?
So when I put my eyeliner on, and then I go shoot.
And also, too, the thin-temple design here, you're going to get a really nice fit around the ears. So this one there, that should be a good style for you, Nikki, going forward.
Here's my biggest thing.
Are you going to SHOT Show?
I am, but I'm so picky on eyewear. I don't like having the crossbar. So I was looking at y'all's notch sunglasses, or sunglasses, safety glasses.
Got them right here.
Because I don't like, if I'm going prone and I need to look up, I don't like there being a crossbar across the top.
There's the notch right here, if you can see.
Mm-hmm.
It's a really nice glass. It gives you much more coverage down here on the side of your face, cheekbones.
Does
very
it still
comfortable
have a
glass.
Nose thing?
That's the same price as the Sharp Edge. They're $29.95. Same nose piece, thermoplastic rubber nose piece.
I'll have to try them on a shot and see what they look like. Because it's just
please
only
do.
When I shoot.
Please come by.
Only when I shoot shotgun, my glasses start sliding. Every other gun, fine. Shotgun, and it's right there at my face.
Yep.
I'm right in my head, glasses start slipping.
Yeah. There you go, Mandy. They got it. Man,
I think that'll be a good solution for you.
Can we stump these people? Is there something that they don't have that doesn't, you know, yet? I mean, what's going on here? She even brought
up the makeup. If you want to pay $200 or $300, we're not there yet. So.
Yeah. There you go. We got some live questions that came in. Big Lou 13 here says, "How big is the XL?" He says he has a big head.
I tell you how we do head. How we size. We size the regular, the standard. For a fitted hat size of 6 3/4 to about 7 3/8, and the Blade Runner XL, we size it from 7.5 to an 8 and beyond. And the other thing about the Blade Runner is, this is the polarized version here. You can actually get a custom fit. You can actually take your fit. You can actually widen them out. See how wide I got them. And if they're too wide, you can tighten them up a little tighter. So you can actually get a custom fit. So Big Lou, those should fit you.
And that's a wide noggin,
Blade
man.
Runner XL.
Yeah, that's a wide. Yeah.
A size 8 hat is a big old melon. So.
I got somebody that's
a pumpkin.
Where
I grew up, we call that
room.
Pumpkin head. So.
Yeah. We have here, we got a couple follow-ups. So a lot of people were concerned about the extra large size. He says, the humble marksman here, he says, so do the large frame models legitimately fit guys with big heads and not look ridiculous, or is this just hype? So is there, other than what you just explained, if you go to the website, there is a fit guide right there.
There is a fit guide, yes.
And if you're, and I don't know, with the way what he just demonstrated there, the way you can kind of widen them out or bring them back in, I mean, I don't see how they're going to look ridiculous on you. So, I mean, like I said.
Not at all.
We still have yet to stump the folks at Edge Tactical Eyewear. All right.
yes.
Says JJCFL. Says, do any of the lenses offer full magnification for us guys with older eyes?
In our safety line, yes. We are working on that with our tactical line. We have magnifiers. Some of our products called the Core, K-H-O-R, the Zorg G2, some of the other lines in our Edge safety eyewear line, we'll have those now. Vapor shield on those lenses are going to be hit and miss. We don't have those on the magnifiers at all. We have not been able to combine the magnifiers and the vapor shield technology. That's why we don't have them on the tactical line. But we do have readers available on the safety line.
Next shot show, there's going to be a 1-4. Somebody's going to be like, what? I'm like, oh, no, I got variable optic. That's weird.
Yeah,
on glasses.
I'm
like,
exactly. Oh,
yeah, it's a 1-6. It's not a big deal. I mean, just...
glasses clear as day. It's great.
Yeah.
Big Lou is also saying, is there a multi-lens product in extra large?
Not in extra large, no. We've got the Acid Gambit, which I would recommend that they try on. It's the same frame style. I've got the Desert Tan one here. It's the same frame style that as a Blade Runner. It's just an open bottom. So, again, you can take these. You can widen them out. You can bring it back, and the lenses pop out. This is the Desert Tan with a polarized copper lens in it. But that's the one I would recommend trying for a multi-lens kit for a larger size head.
You can say a big head. You can say you got a ginormous head. It's okay.
Ginormous.
Pumpkin head.
Yeah. You don't have a ginormous head.
I was like, Dustin's wearing
No, I don't.
You're wearing the peanut head glasses.
Oh, yeah, I got like the baby gap small ones, so it's okay.
Yeah, Lee Cable says he has a size 8 hat.
Dang, son.
Woo! It's like all the people watching have huge
heads.
Yeah. The Blade Runner XL will fit up to an 8.
There you go. A. Jones says, just tuning in, what's the price range? So we talked a little bit about the price range earlier on in the show. I mean, what do they go down to? They go down to below $20, all the way up to what, $79? We talked about for the kit.
$79.95 or something was the most expensive.
That's it. You all get an A for the class tonight. Exactly. Our fast link, which is our basic entry level range class, is at $15.95 full MSRP, and then when you get up to Guardian, Legends Guardian kit, original Guardians World War II issue, or the polarized multicam, those are $79.95. And then we have 2 and 3 lens kits for the Acid Gambit, which are higher. Our Blizzard Goggle is $89.95. And then the Overlord kit is $129.95. So, but again, that's 4 lenses, 2 leashes, a Molly compatible carry bag, and 2 cleaning cloths.
So pretty much between your cup holder in your car and your cushions under your couch, you should scrap up enough change to go get you some nice eyewear and stuff up your game.
I was going to say, so. I don't even think you can get a pair of Oakleys for that, for the Overlord kit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you're not going to get any of their ballistic rated, I'll tell you that much. So this is that's the other thing that I would recommend to your audience is, yeah, it's a good shot of the bag. One of the other things I would recommend to your audience is make sure they know what they're buying. Just because they buy, let's just say Oakley, and Oakley does make some ballistic eyewear. Probably, I'm taking a wild guess here. I'm going to say 95 to 98% of their eyewear is not ballistic, and only 2 to 5% is. So, you know, if you ever want to have doubts on, or if you ever have questions on how sunglasses hold up to ballistic projectiles, we've got a video that I think Anthony's putting up the link. We've got glasses versus a 12-gauge shotgun. And if you ever want to see just what if you get shot in the face with ballistic, with like buckshot, and what glasses do, not just a buckshot, but what the shards of glasses do to your eyes, you'll be amazed. That's why you really, if you're going to shoot, you really need to hold out for ballistic eyewear, ballistic approved eyewear.
There you go. We got some more Q&A stuff. We appreciate you guys bringing those in. We're going to hit them here in a second. We're going to talk some discount codes. We do have a giveaway here. Let's bring that up again if you just tuning in. The Overlord kit. we are going to be giving away. Now, since we were told in the middle of the show, we're going to put together the giveaway at the end of the show. It's just going to be a link. You know, like Edge Tactical Eyewear, like the Shooter's Mindset, put your name and your email in. We'll get you set up. Well, I don't know. We'll do it for like a week or something till next show. So next Wednesday, we'll announce the winner live. We'll get your email over to Kevin, and you'll get yourself an Overlord kit. That's polarized. Comes with all the lenses, the clear, the smoke. You know, I know what's a tiger. What do you call it?
Tiger's eye.
Tiger's eye. I was close there. Almost. Yeah. That's about an 80% on a test there. I'll take it. Still yeah. passing. For me in high school, when I saw 80, man, I was happy. All right, some folks.
Tiger's eye lens too is great to shoot if you're at an indoor range, or if you're going indoors to outdoors back and forth, or if you're shooting outside on an overcast day. That tiger's eye lens with the blue filter and the color generation that comes out of that lens is really very, very nice. I mean, you can wear a clear lens anywhere, obviously, but the tiger's eye lens you can wear almost everywhere, just like you can the clear. So yeah. It's a great looking lens.
All right, so let's get you guys some discount codes here. If you're unfortunate enough to not win the glasses in the giveaway, and you want to pick up some Edge Tactical Eyewear, they have it over at Tactical Shit, so shop.tacticalshit.com. We have a discount code here, TSM10. It'll save you 10% off anything over on their website. So that includes Edge Tactical Eyewear. As far as other discount codes, if we can fly through them quickly, because we got some more stuff to cover on my notes. Dustin, you want to hit us with a few? Do you have?
Yeah, normally I do have a sweet Comptech order or a discount code order. I've been placing orders all day. But you can usually use Dustin 1. He gets 10% off. But right now, you don't use my discount code. Use Cole16, and that's going to give you 15% off. So get a little bit of bonus. And I think that's to like January 2nd or something like that. So if you didn't get anything from Santa, you can use some Cole16, and that'll get you 15% off. You can go to xproducts.com. You can get your sweet side charger uppers. I know we're rocking PPC stuff, and now IDPA, USPSA, and 3-gun. So you can get your sweet 9mm. My SBR is too far out of reach right now. But use Dustin 10. You get 10% off there. Hit me up if you need something with Proper or H&M Black Nitride, because Black Nitride matters. I got some deals from those guys, but you just hit me up on my fan page. And maybe have a Edge Tactical Eyewear code sometime soon. I don't know. Just saying.
Yeah. Sure, we can work that out.
Yeah. And I'll finish up on mine. I know Jen got a couple. Nick's got a couple. Dewey Rods, DeweyRods.com. Nylon-coated rods for all your firearm needs, from 22s to big bore, big action calibers. ASM-15 saves you 15% off. We also got some AR-15 parts over there. The small parts that you – the springs that you lose when you're taking it apart or something like that. The gas blocks, the gas tubes, they have all that. Dewey Rod, check them out. Terran Tactical Innovations, if you want an awesome Benelli M2, you want a tricked-out Combat Master Glock, or you just want some base pads, TSM-10 saves you 10% off. TerranTacticalInnovation.com. Jen, what do you have?
Carbon Arms. You can get 10% off at carbonarms.us for the best shotgun caddies out there. You can use TSM10 to get 10% off. And also Samson Manufacturing, you can get 10% off at samson-mfg.com. It might have a pro in there. Anyway, Google Samson. And you can get 10% off on the best hand guards and scope mounts.
Yeah, I want to talk to Samson, and Scott picks up.
That's yeah. right.
Yeah, if you do see if there's right, like but... if there's like carry-on luggage and stuff, you're at the wrong. You're at Samsonite, not Samson.
Double check. I was that. Way off.
Yeah. Oh, good movie.
There's an IOU in there. You might want to keep that.
Yeah, it's Samson-MFGPro.com. All right, Nikki, what do you have?
Just quickly, American Defense Manufacturing, if you go to AmericanDefenseManufacturing.com, you can use discount code 3GUN10, that's the number 3, the word gun, and the number 10. It'll save you 10% on any American Defense products except for the packages where you combine the light and the rifle package, or the scope and the scope mount packages. Those do not qualify, but any other item on the website, you can get 10% off. Hit me up on Facebook, me, Heath, or our Team Clevenger Shooting page on Facebook, and we can hook you up with a 20% discount for TrueSpec, or a 15%, I think it's 15% discount with Criterion barrels. So we're looking forward to seeing everybody, them down at SHOT Show. Hopefully catch me at SHOT Show. I'll give you that discount code too. But those are my three for this evening.
Excellent. I rounded off here. I got Mindset 16, saves you 15% off RanCLP.com. All right. So all these discount codes are actually in the description box below the video. If we talk too fast and you didn't catch anything, click down there. You'll get those discount codes. All right. All right. So quick, let's do some quick, cause we got some cover. We still got a lot of live questions here that came in, but lightning round for you, Kevin, here, silly questions, some important ones, one or the other type of
stuff. I'm ready.
If you can only shoot a match, all right, this is a competitive match of any sort, and a battle belt or a tactical vest, which one are you choosing?
I'm sorry, I didn't get that.
Battle belt or tactical vest, any competitive shooting match.
You're going to rock a belt or a vest?
A battle belt. Battle belt, come on, man. Yeah.
Yeah.
Pinkus owes me more money still.
Yeah, battle belt is that's what I would use. Okay. Just makes sense. All right, let's see. You're deep in the woods somewhere. You run into some hole-in-the-wall Mexican joint. Are you ordering tacos or burritos?
By that time, I'm probably really hungry. I'm going to order burritos.
Yeah, I think that is the correct answer. Burritos is always the better way to go, in my opinion. Tacos are too played safe. You're going to find out if a Mexican joint really has good food if you go with the burritos over the tacos.
That's right.
Hard shell tacos all day.
Yeah, Bruce Lee. Chuck Norris get into a fight in their prime. Movies aside, who do you have winning?
Bruce Lee.
Bruce Lee.
He's faster.
How much would we have paid to see this in the ring, a real deal fight, man? You know, Bruce Lee went too early. I think it could have happened eventually. Probably not. But, man, it would have been worth every penny.
Lightning round.
Yeah. All right, what do we got? I'll throw one more out on my end, and then your girls can take it over. You're going into a bar. All they have is Jameson and Jack Daniels. Which one are you drinking?
Jack Daniels all day.
Yeah, I don't care. But
whatever's free, right?
Is it booze? Then I like it. Then I like
it.
Does it have alcohol in it?
Can I has, please?
Yes, but now for the important questions.
Very
and
important.
I'll ask one and Nikki can ask one.
Yes. And as soon as I finish yelling at my dog.
A right and a wrong answer for this. So Oreos or Chips Ahoy?
I'm sorry, what was that?
Oreos or Chips Ahoy?
I gotta go Oreos.
Yes.
Oh, I'm not coming by the booth.
Gotta go Oreos.
I am though.
Delicious.
Second.
No, it's
Chips Ahoy. This question. Okay.
It's gotta be
okay.
Enough.
You pick the one that I like. Now
Oreos. Oreos are America's cookie.
Yes,
that's true.
What? It's a chocolate chip is a classic. Classic.
Yeah.
Oreos, though.
But it's got to be the chewy ones. If we're going to go that route, it can't be like the sawdust ones. That's
yeah. Those always come hard. Yeah, they always they fall apart by the time you open a sleeve.
All right, next one.
It's true.
There's one more question, and you can redeem yourself on this one.
Okay.
Thinking Girl Scouts, Thin Mints, or Samoas?
Thin Mint.
Yes.
There we go. All right. We're good.
It's a Jennifer kind of night.
Tonight is your night, Jennifer. I'll give it to you this time. I'll give you the deal.
You always get the sour end of the lightning round.
Nobody ever – I don't know why I get disappointed. Nobody ever picks Chips Ahoy or Samoas. I am the only –
It's because I have the superior picks.
You're unique.
I like unique better than Jennifer saying she's superior taste.
I have superior cookie taste.
You're special.
Hey, but I do like the white Oreos.
Once again, special. Nobody likes vanilla Oreos.
I'm telling y'all, these teeth. I cannot get Oreos all up in that. I got a lot of teeth.
That's all you would see.
Yeah. Do they have those in the South? I think so.
I'm not. Who brings a toothbrush with them everywhere they go to eat Oreos?
I know a few people. Not me. Who goes out in public and eats Oreos?
You're not going to eat a whole bag
on your couch, and you're eating a sleeve at a time. I'm not with like family that I'm like, oh hey, let me wine and dine you. Let me pop out this Oreo.
Hashtag not so lightning.
It just got serious.
Yeah. Oreos don't even come in sleeves anymore.
What? You're not buying the jumbo pack, apparently. Then.
Apparently. Yeah.
You don't hate yourself enough yet.
That's alrighty. We've got some. We're gonna hit some more live. Dustin, you had one off the Facebook, right?
Yes. Let me go back to that.
I got some here in the meantime. When you hold on to that one,
yeah.
Because you guys were the first to offer polarized safety glasses. How'd you come up with that idea of making safety glasses polarized? And do we need to see it somewhere? Do we see a need for it somewhere in particular?
Yes. Well, it originally came up with a lot of the maritime operations. A lot of people that are working on ships, the glare that you get from the water was just really, really strong. And so, polarized sunglasses, and then there were safety glasses. And so, what the owner of our company, Kurt Dames, was able to do was bring the technology together to bring a gradient polarized lens into a ballistic safety rated lens set and frame, so that safety workers, industrial, and anybody. And now on our tactical line, we have these. We have a lot of Coast Guardsmen, men and women. We have a lot of Navy, Border Patrol, that work along the water. That need to protect their eyes, not only for vision, but also from potential flying projectiles. We were able to do that. So, and the gradient polarized lens too, what that does is it knocks down the glare, reduces the glare from the top, and it also reduces the reflection from the bottom. So basically you're just looking out the center of the eye and or the center of the lens, looking up or down, or straight ahead, you're getting the same view. Either way you look.
Sweet, man. I mean,
nice.
What do you got, Dustin, on the Facebook?
Okay, Mr. Fox Jr. says, "What is the best save story?" And actually, I have one with Edge Technical Eyewear. But what is the best save story? Like, these glasses saved my eyes. What is the best story you got?
Oh, we get them all the time. Had a Texas Department of Public Safety. He wasn't a Texas Ranger. He worked for DP or for Texas Public Safety TPS. Was riding an ATV and had a branch, a pretty heavy tree branch, came by, and he was riding at dusk. Couldn't see, or not see well enough to see things from the peripheral side. Actually, he was wearing one of our polarized copper Hamels, and the branch actually hit his lens center mass, and had at the rate he was traveling, rate of speed, had that had his safety lens not caught that, then the lens probably would have gone right through the center of his eye. Mm-hmm. So that was, and this is somebody I'd met personally in my travels. So it was great when he called me the next day and said, "Hey, your glasses literally saved my eye last night." Really made me feel good. And it's why we get up in the morning. It's why we go to work. It's what we do. Our call sign or our call tag is defend your vision, and that's something that we're very passionate about at Edge Tactical Eyewear. So when we get these kind of stories and we hear these things from shooters or law enforcement professionals, it really, really makes a difference in what we do. It makes us want to work harder to develop new and better styles for everybody to wear.
There you go. Dustin, you got a story you want to share with them?
Yeah, so obviously, like I said, I wear these bad boys day in and day out for now coming up on almost 3 years. And I've actually had, in a class, multiple shooters, a ricochet come back and smoke me center line in the glasses. The only scratch in 2-3 years of doing everything and beating the hell out of these bad boys. The only scratch is a little ding I could probably take a photo tomorrow. They're on my office desk. But those, that thing, it hit center of my lens. And yeah, definitely, if I didn't have glasses on or didn't have quality glasses on, it definitely would have screwed me up pretty bad. So definitely saved my eyeballs that day.
Yeah. Yeah, anybody, I know there's probably a lot of people that are like, hey, man, I never had an incident where I needed ballistic eyewear, you know, or if you're a shooter, you know, I shoot quite a bit of Steel Challenge. And anybody who shoots Steel Challenge, the ricochet that comes back on some of these steels, obviously they try to place them where that doesn't happen, but I haven't been to a major steel match or a local where someone hasn't caught a ricochet off of steel. So
that's what I'm saying. If you've ever been hit by a piece,
yeah,
you pulled it out of your skin and it bled, yeah, I always look at that and think, what if that was my face? Like, what if that was my eye? Yeah. Yes, I'm lucky I got it in the hand or the arm or the, you know, in the leg or something. But what if that was my face?
I have been smoked, like, right in the cheek, right underneath my lenses. and it, I mean, it's, you know, swelled up a little bit and then gave me a nice little cut on it that did
bleed. You wear the Nelly Band-Aid?
I did. I'm from St. Louis, so it's cool.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, that last steel match, it was a Florida, I think it was the Florida State Steel Challenge Championship. It was up in Gainesville, Florida. And I don't know what it was about that stage, but the SO went down. He went down, and I picked up. So they switched. So the scorekeeper went to RO, and I grabbed the scoreboard. And then one came back at me, hit me dead chest. And I had just a huge bruise of it. And I swear it was in there. Went to the doc. And he says, no, it's not in there. But, dude, imagine if that would hit your face or your cheek. That's going to – it's like someone punched you good in the eye.
Or if it hit these big old teeth, it would just be like having Oreos up in there. Just screw everything up.
So, yeah, man, you need if you're in any field of shooting sports at all, whether that's skeet shooting or whatever it is, PRS stuff, you need ballistic wear. And you need some good ballistic stuff. And these – come at a great price, like I said. I mean, you can.
Thank you.
Another thing I'm gonna bring up here. One thing, I'm big into fishing. Everybody, well, it's a side hobby, not huge into fishing because shooting takes over, and I can't afford both. But when it comes to fishing, do you have any lenses that help aid seeing that water better?
Polarized. Yeah, dude. Trout fishing.
Gradient polarized smoke lens plus our polarized copper lens would both work well. On our safety line, we have a reflective blue and a reflective orange, but on my side of the house, the gradient polarized smoke that Dustin's got on right now, or the polarized copper, either one of those work very, very well.
Yeah, as soon as the season kicks around, man, I'll be on the trout stream with these bad boys on, because yeah, definitely trout fishing. I rock polarized lenses, and now I got these things, so. Yeah, you'll see photos of me in a fly vest and not shooting IDPA. Maybe, I don't know. I could instantly.
So that's where the fishing vest comes into play. I never knew that actually fishes with a vest on.
And it frowned upon me shooting into the water.
Isn't that something like shooting fish in a barrel?
Yeah, everybody looks at me weird when I start shooting trout in the stream. I don't know.
Yeah. Oh, man. What else do we got? Anything live? I don't know. Let me check my end. It seems like applied. Okay, so what do we got here? From the humble marksman here, does the tiger's eye color make red fiber optics on the gun sights? Does it make it pop?
Oh, that's a good question.
I haven't tested that. But that's a good question. I'd like to know the answer to that one myself.
Yeah, hang on. Let's just product testing.
Yeah, Dustin's got one of everything there. He should be able to.
I say, and you know Dustin has a gun near him.
Oh, you need a gun. Hang
you on. Know two things about Dustin. He has a jersey on, and there's always a gun next to him.
At all times.
At all times.
We're nice and safe and clear and whatnot. Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. That's live.
But is it popping?
All right, there we go. Yeah. Thank you.
It's and I'm not in a super. I mean, I'm inside my kitchen here, my living room, and I got a lamp and I got my center light, so it's not the super illuminated like you would be outside. And I do got some nice little tiger stripe, little tiger eyes right there.
Tiger's eye. Yeah. And you know what? The conditions you're talking about, Dustin, are perfect for that lens. Yeah.
Let's see if we can do something about
I was about to say, put it up to the camera and then put the sight up to see if we can see.
Oh, there we go.
It's the eye of the tiger.
Without, like, aiming a gun right at my face.
Oh, it does, actually.
Hey, I saw it for a second there.
There we go.
Dang.
We have to hire you guys to join our research and development department.
I would say, Dustin, you got to talk so it makes your screen bigger.
Okay. So,
oh, yeah, that is good. Look at that.
It is actually really bright. Yeah.
Wow.
So that's probably the worst, like, demonstration. My glasses are just like, let me see if I can just start my screen field here real quick.
Here you go, internet.
Look at that. You ask and you shall receive.
It's on the internet. It's got to be true.
Yep.
That's right.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dustin.
There you go. There's an on-the-fly red fiber optic test right there. So
love it.
Is from Lee Cable here. It says, is Edge Eyewear and Edge Tactical the same company?
Edge Eyewear is our parent company. Actually, the corporate structure is called Wolf Peak International, based out of Layton, Utah. We have three divisions. We have Edge Safety Eyewear, Edge Eyewear Canada, and Edge Tactical Eyewear.
There you go. He also says Tactical Shit doesn't stock the XL size on the website.
Uh-oh.
Hey, you holler at...
There we go. Gotta get on, Dustin.
Or you holler at TJ or send me a message. We'll get it happening, man.
What's your email? Plus, send him an email. Send Dustin an email if you don't have him on Facebook or you don't have Facebook.
Yeah. You can shoot me an email at Dustin Pluth, Pluth, @gmail.com, or just hit up the Tactical Shit guys, and we'll just streamline it. Yes, I'll see it in the messages and whatnot, since I'm an admin, but it'll go streamlined straight to either Mr. Motard himself, and he does all the special orders, or TJ, the owner, pretty much the head honcho there, and he'll do the orders. He'll get you some stuff, and you can use the TSM10 discount code to get your 10% off. So we'll make it happen.
Yeah.
For all you big heads out there.
Yeah.
JJCFL says, so, yeah, so the burrito with Jack Daniels on the rocks and Oreos for dessert.
Boom.
That's what we recommend.
Sign me up.
That's America. What we are recommending.
I'm so glad that I'm married because there's nobody out there for me.
Yeah.
He's like, what did I do? Oh, and apparently, just so everybody knows, Heath texted me or emailed me, and his email apparently is not mikeoncho@gmail.com. So sorry if I was trying to hook him up.
Yeah.
Everybody's, I'll say, whoever Mike Honcho is going to get a bunch of emails about.
Just getting blown up on the internet.
What do you guys use for dry fire drills?
Yeah.
All right, here. Lee Cable got to one that he asked twice here that I missed. He says, what's the deal with gasket? Pre-applied gasket. I don't know. Oh. You know what he means by this?
Yeah, we do have two different type of foam gaskets. We have one. There you go. We have one set that are pre-applied in the factory, or you can peel and stick them if you like. They're about $5 extra. What they do is they give you a firm seal around the eye. So if you're riding a motorcycle, or if you just want a tight seal around the eye, you can do that. Our Blade Runner and Blade Runner XL both have removable gaskets now, and they're the same price, $5 each. And you can actually snap those in and out, which make are very easy to do. So
what he's showing you right now, or what he's talking to you about right now, is this foam insert that goes along the brim and then down the side to it.
There you go.
Just like that.
Hey, that would be really good for the people that don't know how to shoot and they like let the recoil pop their stuff into their face. And then it'll cushion it so they don't get such bruises.
I was thinking, like, if something came off and hit you in the eye, it's, like, also provides a little cushion for when it hits
We should call that the airbag system.
There you go.
Boom, trademark.
I'm telling you, every episode we come up with a new idea that seriously needs to be taken in consideration by every company we talk to.
I mean, Pincus owes me a lot of money from the Battle Belt system, so...
And we got to check out that new pistol that he's advertising, too.
He keeps dodging me, though, man. Why you keep ducking me, Pincus?
It's coming out with Eagle Import.
You know, you owe me money.
Maybe that Lee says Kaper something.
Says Dustin, he's going to order some XLs tomorrow, so you should be getting an email on some XLs.
Sounds good, man.
All right.
Shoot it over to the tactical shit guys. If you send it to me, I'll forward it to them, but just send one less step because I get all busy and stuff and I forget. And yeah, I'm special.
So hit them up in a – go to Tactical Shit Facebook page. Hit them up in a private message there.
Yep.
And that'll streamline and get your stuff ordered.
Hey, yeah. Speaking about that Pincus gun, it'll be at SHOT Show at the Eagle Imports booth.
There you go.
Just saying.
It's funny. It has a name to it, but we just call it the Pincus gun for some reason because he's a, you know.
They'll actually have his picture with him holding it on their on their banner.
He does a good job at marketing that.
The Pincus gun. There it is.
Pincus gun. Yeah. All right. So what else do we got?
Goggles.
Those are the Googles.
Now, are those ballistic rated?
Everything we make is ballistic safety rated. Everything. And those goggles are the only ones in the industry that will not fog if you break the seal from the inside. They will not fog on the inside.
So the cool part is that back in a second life ago, I actually played semi-professional paintballs. And so I traveled the country and did some stuff. And these lenses break apart the same way as JT lenses or everybody else in the industry. Any of your goggles for your paintball stuff. So I was so pumped to change them out for the smoked and did all of that. So it's a very, very easy, very fast snap system in. Literally by just, if I can do this, literally you just pop off the lens just that easy. Or you can just unsnap them and then literally you just snap them back in.
I'm just wondering if goggles will fix my issue with the glasses sliding down my face.
This would be
you
awesome.
You would look amazing in those goggles. I think you should wear them.
Yeah. I wonder
start
how
a new fad.
How low do they fit on your face, Dustin? If you put a shotgun up to your face, would you? Or a rifle. You have a shotgun or rifle next to you? Of course you do.
Of course. Who are you talking to? Did you see his picture on Christmas?
Yeah.
That was epic, by the way, Dustin.
I don't got a shotgun. I know, dude. So if anybody's seen my Christmas post, that was me as a contractor elf. So we did Tactical Santa. So
that was so funny.
That's literally like me like pushing in hard, getting major cheek weld.
So you can still see through the red dot.
Oh yeah.
No breaking the.
Let me just pop off my Vortex Spark AR here.
Why don't you point that one at yourself?
Yeah, let's not just give the internet more fuel. So, yeah, dude, I'm game on. It's all. So
we're also designing a low profile goggle right now, which we're going to launch sometime in 2017, which I'm really excited about. A lot of agencies are going more to a lower profile goggle, and the one we have prototyped up is really, really nice. So like looking forward to getting that out. And it'll be vapor shield as well. So
there you go. And that kind of leads me into the last question I have on my notes here. Any upcoming products that you have to talk about? You just talked about the low profile goggle, but upcoming matches, any shows, any projects that Edge Tactical has coming up here?
Well, we do over 300 shows a year with between Edge Safety Eyewear, Edge Canada, and Edge Tactical Eyewear, so we're constantly out in the public. One of the things that we've done is, you know, I talked in the very beginning of the show, we don't do billboards. You're not going to see us sponsoring the Super Bowl, things like that. What we try to do is go out to as many local, regional, national type shooting shows, law enforcement agency shows that we can get into and really demonstrate this eyewear to people because you know, you said you hadn't heard about it, and you were kind of skeptical. Well, we get that all the time. So we want people to come to our booth at these shows. SHOT Show coming up in a few weeks. That's our Super Bowl booth 30011. We'll have a 20x40 booth size. We're in the law enforcement pavilion over to the side. We'd love for everybody, every supporter of TSM to come out and visit with us there and show your new products, We're launching a Thin Temple Blade Runner, which is a it's already a great fitting frame with the combination rubber and TR90 nylon. But then when you add the Thin Temple design to the side, it's going to be even that much more comfortable. So we're also working on a few other things. In April at the FDIC show in Indianapolis, we'll be launching a new tribute glass for firefighters, similar to what we did this past year for Legends Guardian for the police. We'll be doing one for the firefighters as well. And it's a great, great looking glass. Again, it'll be in a package deal.
Yeah, the one for the law enforcement one, that's a Legend series, and it has
it's Guardian. Blue
line
yes.
It, Guardian, and it has blue lines running,
yeah.
running to the frame.
Flag with a blue line, yes.
So they, yeah. they look very awesome.
The old school, like World War II bomber ones are pretty sick too. Like going down the whole side here, it has like the tiger or like the shark mouth to it. Mm-hmm. And it looks like the side of a P-51 Mustang would kind of be. So that's a really cool look too as well.
Yeah.
Actually, the story behind that's really cool. It's the old 666 bombing crew. They were in World War II. They were actually shot down. They went to a junkyard or a boneyard to find spare parts. They rebuilt the plane, went back up and flew 17 more missions. So it's actually a series of three glasses. One is death proof. One is Boneyard, and one's Cataclysm. So you can see those on our website. We talked earlier about not selling direct. Edge Tactical Eyewear doesn't sell direct at all. We go through our local dealers, our distributors. We're a small business ourselves, and we're a huge proponent of promoting small business. So that's why we really work with only authorized dealers, authorized distributors, to sell our product. We want people to know our product, to know our brand, to know how to sell our product, and we want people that we can count on and partner up with.
Right on. Yeah, I wouldn't be too surprised. I'm just definitely going to go to SHOT Show, going to visit the booth, going to get them in my hands, and I wouldn't be too surprised if you see some Edge Tactical Eyewear over on the shootersmindset.com.
You could probably do one that I really want, one that says like Shooters and then Mindset on the lens, actually, though. That'd be
can we get that laser etched in there?
Because I do like Fig Newtons, but this logo is dangerous and inconvenient. We just have the logo right across the lens. That'd be awesome.
In the pre-show, when we were off here, I talked to him about some customizing some. So that is possible. So hey, if you own a retail shop or something, or if you're an online retailer and you want to do something custom, you can hit them up.
Sure.
We have all their information down. What I got right now, it's already a link to the website down in the description box below. But I got edgeeyewear.com. Mm-hmm. You can also plug in Edge Tactical Eyewear, and it all comes up on a search. See, they have blown away by all the different colors and styles and models they have, you know, so there's definitely something for everybody's taste with Edge Tactical here. So summary of the show, I don't know, pretty much you can't stump Edge Tactical Eyewear. They have stuff for the big headed folks. They have stuff for the tiny headed folks like Ken. They have goggles. They have polarized safety eyewear. They're the first ones to come out with that. They're supporting the law enforcement guys, the military guys, their shooters themselves, their cyclists. I mean, I don't know. What else can I say to convince you here?
And y'all are about to start rocking them fishing.
Boom.
Yeah. Fishing, casual wear.
Look, I'm ready for summer, so I'm ready for some sunglasses.
Every time I never wore like prescription glasses in my life. And you know, knock on wood, anywhere I can find it, I'm sure eventually the vision will go. But you always sit on glasses. I mean, it's like it's always going to happen. Anybody else who had glasses that was around me, I sat on them and I broke them. The little hinge thing is what you break. Boom. It's done.
Mine fall off my head.
Yeah. So those are this glasses bent to hell and tied in a knot. So check that.
Yeah. So, I mean, this is like, how do they make money? I don't know, because one pair will last forever. All right, there you go.
So I know we didn't say anything about it, but all the glasses come in nice, awesome little package here that shows all that you're getting. And then in the package, you do get your little microfiber little baggie here. But then definitely these are awesome. They got a Molly strap on the back, so you can stick it onto your gear. This is straight up going on my proper backpack on the side of it. So I always have my eyewear. They got a little pouch on the top that you can stick all your goodies and things in there.
Oh, and then, snacks.
Yeah,
you can get a travel size pack of like Oreos.
I could put like two Oreos in there.
You could probably even get double stuff.
So you know how you're gonna be like, okay, this is 4 inches by 3 inches here. You're gonna be like, actually, the pocket size is 2 inches, but it can definitely stack in about 3 Oreos. That's actually gonna be in the Edge Tech.
I was thinking the mini Twix or Kit Kats.
Yeah. That's okay too. Yeah. So
yeah,
little Molly bag there that you got your cleaning cloth. You can stick that bad one.
Possibilities are endless.
Endless possibilities.
How many? If I could add,
that's like a half a sleeve of Oreos you could stick in there as well. So buy one for your glasses, then get another one
for your snacks.
For your snack pack.
There you go.
Boom. And then when you're super hungry, you can up your game. That's like a half. That's a whole sleeve of Oreos could go in there.
Oh my gosh, you could dump a whole bag of Chips Ahoy in there, you know?
Yeah,
it'd be and cool, you know what?
And sawdust in a minute.
Girl Scouts have downsized the number of cookies you get, so you could probably fit a whole box of Girl Scout cookies in.
Yeah, step up your game, girls.
Yeah, downsize. Ripping us off. Less cookies, more money. Girl Scouts support them.
I'm addicted though.
All right.
Hey, on the glasses too. When you're cleaning the glasses, make sure that you only use, make sure you use a cleaning bag, first of all, the microfiber cleaning bag that we include with the glasses. But also, if that's not enough, use warm water and a little bit of dishwasher detergent. Nothing any stronger than that. You don't want to spray these with window cleaner or anything. There's two coatings that you can rub off with chemicals. One is the anti-scratch compound. We didn't talk about that, but with ANSI standard, you have to have an anti-scratch coating on the lenses. What we do, though, is we provide 3 times the ANSI standard. So we've got a pretty good anti-scratch coating on there. We get the complaints a lot, some of these brands that are charging $150, $200. As soon as you drop them, they scratch up. Ours don't do that. They're very scratch resistant. The other one is a UV coating. All of our eyewear is protected to 99.9% of UV protection. So you want to make sure that you leave that UV coating on there and the anti-scratch coating on there. So again, microfiber cleaning bag first. If that doesn't work, a little bit of warm water. And if you really mudded them up, then just a little bit of mild dishwashing detergent. So.
There you go. I got one more live one here that I think is important. I want to get out here. JB Screech says, does the foam block ventilation and cause fogging?
No, it will not cause fogging. Again, the chemical compound for the vapor shield is embedded into the lens.
Inside, outside, it doesn't matter.
This viewer.
Yeah.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. The viewer is probably thinking about the ones that spray on or wipe on with some of the other brands. That's actually an application that you put on after the fact. You don't ever have to put anything on our lenses. They're actually the military grade anti-fog compound is built into the lens. So you can get as hot as you want. I'll tell you a story. Last summer, I was in Virginia Beach, Virginia, working with some of the guys from the Special Warfare Group, and they took our goggles out. Some of the SEALs. And some of the SEAL trainees out there on Chesapeake Bay, and they couldn't get them to fog up. They could not. The only thing they mentioned to us was that there were sometimes the guys were working out so hard and heavy that they would get pools of sweat under their eyes. So that was be the only thing. But they said they could not get those goggles to fog up no matter what. So we were very happy to hear that testing went well with those folks.
Yeah, everybody has a complaint. And it seems like Edge has the remedy for it. So if you don't want the bar across like Nikki doesn't like, they have a set of glasses for that. If you get the if you wear earmuffs while you're shooting, you always get that you get that pinch right here between your eyes, your ears, and all that stuff, and then eventually it all it ends up uncomfortable. They got a solution for that. Tiny heads, big heads, they got it all, right? So, I mean, I don't know. Oh, and the other problem that I ran into, is that your dog snoring? Because that is
yes, can y'all hear it for real? How are y'all?
That is, dude, that's like having a dude that's next impressive. To you snoring.
That's, and I know, she's all the way across the room, y'all, and it's a girl, it's my little girl. Ryder, shh.
Well, those are, that's the thing about them dogs, their nose.
Is, you know. Can't
breathe.
Damn it.
That's
rough.
I lost my chain of thought. You know, that's
I don't even hear it anymore.
That's how I know. That's what it was. Oh, and the fog thing. When you're shooting a match early, early in the Florida, 8 o'clock in the morning, stage one, you're fogging up. You don't have that issue. So it's the remedy for all things here. All right. So I think we're going to wind this one down here to shout outs here. If you guys are going to the show, check them out at SHOT Show. 3-0-0-1-1
3-0-0-1-1
That's correct.
Already got it written down.
3-0-0-1-1
Shout outs. We're gonna start off with Nikki. What do you got?
I wasn't ready. Just quick, go down through my list. Shout out to Criterion Barrels, American Defense Manufacturing. Oh, I should say SHOT Show Boots. I know we're still a couple weeks away, but Heath and I, the Team Club, will be at SHOT Show this year, only for 2 days. So catch us there Tuesday and Wednesday of the show. We'll be at Criterion Barrels booth 4342 from 1 till 3 on Tuesday. I'll only be there 1 till 2 on Tuesday. But Heath will be there 1 to 3 on Tuesday. American Defense Manufacturing booth 8506. We don't have set times for there, but you can definitely catch us hanging out with those guys because they're super cool. Eagle Imports, we will be there the majority of our time. Come check out their booth 2610. They got a huge booth. You can check out that new Pincus gun. It'll be there. Probably Rob Pincus will be there hanging out. I don't really know who he is, but
Tell him to give me money.
I don't know who the Pincus is.
Y'all, honestly, I don't know.
Tell Pincus, why are you dodging Dustin?
If I recognize him, I will tell him.
He's kind of like a bald guy. And
we'll have a really fancy
he usually
suit
dresses
on.
Up in a really fancy suit. It's
he's good looking.
I'll look for him. I'll look for him. But you can catch Heath and me there at the Eagle Imports booth, 2610. And Rob Pincus's big picture will be behind us, so I guess I can look at that and spot him. Both mornings, Tuesday and Wednesday. TruSpec, got to shout out them. I'll be with Anthony and possibly Jennifer and Dustin at 2 o'clock on Tuesday at the TruSpec booth. They're going to be talking to us about some new products they have coming out. So catch us there. Also want to shout out the rest of my sponsors. Now I can put that down because I don't even have those booth numbers memorized yet. Got a shout out. Shop your local gun shop. Mine is the Outdoor Shop. If you don't have a local gun shop, you can check mine out at the outdoorshop.rocks. Also want to shout out Stage Zero Shooting Supply. He's here, kind of local to me. He's also Donnie Flo. Hit him up. Great guy. Can help you get some gear to get started in the sport. He also can get you one of those sweet SPS Panteras that Heath and I have been shooting these last couple years. So hit up Donnie Flo with Stage Zero Shooting Supply. Shout out Safariland, Techwear, ZT Knives, Tough Products. Definitely going to check out Tough Products while we're there. If you saw the show, was it last week, 2 weeks ago?
Yeah.
They're going to have flasks, but you got to be one of the first ones there, so nobody show up so I can get one.
I will be there for the flask. That's the only reason why I'm going. No, I'm just kidding.
Other than that, I got a shout-out local law enforcement, all law enforcement, and then shout-out to D&D Clover Hill Bullies for my newest member of my family, our sweet little Hoss dog out of North Carolina. D&D Clover Hill Bullies.
You're sponsored by a dog so breeder?
No, I'm just shouting them out. I'm not sponsored by them. No, I paid for that. Yeah. I paid for that little nugget. That wasn't none of those free product sponsorships.
Did it come with some EarPro?
It should. No, that's my grown bulldog snoring. My puppy hasn't developed enough in the face to snore yet.
Nice.
But he was having, y'all, I'm not ready for this. I've never had a young boy dog He started humping something the other day. I'm not ready. I'm not ready. He's only like 3 months old. Why is he humping stuff?
Because he's a boy.
Yeah. All right, Jen, you're up. Shout out to you.
Sorry, shout out to my dog humping beds. Sorry, I don't know.
I just have to say, before I do my shout outs, did y'all know Debbie Reynolds died today?
What's yes, I saw that.
That's Princess Leia's mom.
Mom.
Yeah, she died on Wednesday, and now she died today. Yeah, anyway. Wow. I just saw that. Sorry. Squirrel. So, sponsors, thanking them. Wonderful people in my life. Lansing Tactical for awesome rifles. Load Up Ammunition. Sharpshooters of Augusta and Shooters of Augusta. Terran Tactical Innovations. Zero Tolerance Knives. Lucas Oil for all of your lube needs. Carbon Arms. Night Force. Grizzly Targets. Blade Tech and Sampson Manufacturing.
You're sponsored by Night Force now?
Short and sweet. We're in talks. I want to thank them for a good year.
I was gonna say, sometimes you just thank people because you like them. I'm not sponsored by Tough Products or ZT Knives or Tekka.
I'm hearing a lot of new shout outs here.
I like that. I like them.
I'm hearing dog breeders. I'm hearing Night Force scopes. I'm hearing.
Well, y'all, this puppy is too cute. Yeah.
All right, Dustin, shout outs.
Just can't even. All right, as always, the great people over at Springfield Armory going to be over at that booth. I won't even get into booth stuff yet. I'm going to have a whole thing. I'll be there. I'll be over there. There's times. There's numbers involved. Don't worry about it right now. I'll tell you later. So Springfield Armory Custom Shop. Proper. I'll be over at Proper's booth. They're going to have a ginormous booth. Some new stuff coming out from those guys. Big shout out to Tactical Shit for being the show sponsor. X Products, Rise Armaments. I'll be at both X Products and Rise Armaments booths as well. H&M Black Nitride, because Black Nitride matters. Black Nitride the world. Spencer Race Guns, Comtech Holsters, Pro Ears, Greg Skaz Photography, Justin in Arms, BBI Bullets inside my awesome hardcore ammunition that I'm running. S3F Solutions, Vortex, the great Edge Tactical Eyewear. Saving my eyes with their awesome googlies. And American Manufacturing for awesome silencers that I got my 45 cannon. So there's going to be big things coming from that guy. And then, check me out on the Facebooks. And that's it. Boom.
Kevin, you're finally up. Sorry, we had to work through a lot of our...
Got to give a shout out to Dustin for rocking those incredible looking goggles, man. I tell you, you rock them as well as anybody. Goggles. So, TSM Universe, thanks for having me in. Big fan of the show. Hope you guys just continue to kick it every week. And sorry I couldn't make last time that I was supposed to, but the flu bug has just been going around everybody this year. But I'm back, healthy, ready to go. And look forward to seeing everybody in Vegas, booth 30011.
TSM Universe, is that like?
Is that our fan club?
Is that like the Believers?
That's everybody, man.
We have groupies.
Is it the Justin Bieber fans, the Believers? what is it? Beyonce, the Beehive? I don't know.
We were talking about how people recognize us out and about, not even in the shooting worlds. Like, Jen, I forgot where you were at eating foods, and I was
Christmas
at Lowe's.
Christmas Eve at Waffle House.
Jackpot.
Is like, oh, my God, I know you. And I was like, okay.
That's Waffle House. Very weird. I know I was at Lowe's one time, and a guy across the hallway just kept looking at me, and I was like, And he's like, are you on a show? And I'm like, yes, I actually am.
Yeah.
So now we have the universe. That's what you shall be called from now on. Trademark.
Yeah. I don't know if I like it, but I think Kevin's onto something here.
Yeah, we need a fan club.
All right, I'm gonna try to work through some of the shout outs here. Definitely subscribe to the channel right below the video. If you're watching on the YouTube side of things, you'll see a subscribe button every Wednesday 9 p.m. Eastern. We do a new episode of the Shooter's Mindset. I think who do we have coming up next? I think there might be Taryn Butler up next for the third time. We might have Taryn Butler back on the show. If you want to email me, theshootersmindset@gmail.com is a good way to do that. Shout out to Tactical Shit for always showing us support throughout the year. Shout out to Kevin for spending, 2 hours standing, it seems. Looks like he's standing
for
about 2 hours.
He's getting his workout for SHOT Show.
And look how neat, if you rewind, look how neat his display was behind him. And now look at it.
Yeah. That's the end of the day.
This is my basement too. I was like rigging this up earlier. So trying to make it.
So that's like hour one. Make it look good. To like hour five at a trade show is like the first half of the show. And then hour like six to eight of a trade show, it looks like this and like torn shirt and like half a beard. I don't even know why you grow half a beard, but you're just that way at the end of the trade show. And you're like, let me tell you about some iPro. Do it.
But you know, the funny part is I'm the OCD guy at trade shows. I'm the guy walking around, you know, putting everything back in its place. But I didn't want to turn my back to everybody here, so I figured I would just leave it.
Drop.
And
there we go.
You know, well, let it go.
It makes it look good here, so you can see how much stuff we covered on this display.
Yeah, you could do like Dustin and like wear five pairs at once.
Yeah. That's actually the secret behind it. I'm just like, oh, let me demo these real fast for you here. Hang on. Boom.
Yeah.
iPro.
There we go. We're going to give definitely a shout out to Rise Armament for some fine AR-15 triggers and rifles. If you're going out to Range Day, Media Range Day, which is the Monday right before SHOT Show, I will be at the Rise Armament booth out in the desert. Hand you a rifle.
Hand a 308 rifle.
You rack it, and you go to town. All right, and I'll just stand next to you and talk to you about something.
And then you can say something about like, "Ha ha, Dylan's not here."
Yeah,
because he's sucking it.
And I can tell you about the rifle and why it's awesome. And you're gonna be like, "Wow, that's an awesome trigger." And then I can be like, "Here's some edge tactical eyewear too." Boom, boom, done. Everybody wins.
Yeah.
All right. There you go. That's it. And I'll be at the Rise Armament booth popping. That's gonna be like the hub. I don't have any scheduled celebrity times or anything like that. I usually don't do those. Dustin does them, not me. But I'll be there. You guys can probably spot me if you care. S3F Solutions. And I'm going to narrow it down to this. Nate Square Tactical Holsters inside the waistband. Super comfortable. Check them out. Nate Square Tactical Holsters. That'll do it for episode 164 of The Shooter's Mindset. Thank you guys for watching tonight. Jen, Nikki, Dustin, thanks for helping me out with this tonight. And we're out of here.
Later.